Today we are going to talk about the nucleotide database. This nucleotide database is present in National Center for Biotechnology Information, which is a hub of many different databases. To explore this database, we will click on this National Center for Biotechnology Information, and then we will land to the next page. And on this next page, there is going to be this drop-down menu. So if you will click on here on this drop-down menu, you could have an idea that how many different databases are present here in this NCBI. So you can see it here that there is assembly, biocollections, bioprojects, biosamples, books, etc. and etc. These are all different type of databases. Some of the databases are primary in nature, some of the databases are secondary, while some of the databases are specialized in nature. So let's spend a few moments to understand that what does it mean by the primary, what does it mean by the secondary, and what does it mean by the specialized databases. The primary databases are those databases where the primary information is stored. And what is the primary information? The primary information which is directly coming from the experiment. For example, you did the sequencing, and after the sequencing, you are going to submit that sequencing data into the primary database. And nucleotide database is an example of a primary database. The secondary databases are those which are going to have a derived information, and that information is basically coming from the primary data. So these type of the databases which are going to store the derived information, they are known as a secondary databases. For example, you translated the nucleotide sequence into the protein. Now that protein is a derived information which is obtained from a primary data. Now that derived information will be stored into the secondary databases, and a triangle is an example of the secondary database. Specialized databases are those databases which are going to have information about the one particular domain of biology. These type of databases are known as the specialized databases. For example, the OMIM, online inheritance, online Mendelian inheritance in man. This is a specialized database, and this database only contains an information about the human genetic disorders. But right now we are interested in primary database, and this primary database is a nucleotide database. So what we will do, we will click on this nucleotide, and then in the search bar we will write down our query. So let's assume that CNGA3 is a gene sequence which I want to search. So I will write down it here, CNGA3, and I will click on this search button. So my query will be searched into a database, and then later on I will have the results. So you can actually see it here that on this page there are, I'm going to have an idea that there are 1066 results which are related to my query in the NCBI nucleotide database. And among these 1066 results, there are going to be the 20 which are displayed here on this page. These are the 20 results which are displayed here on this page. Now if I go to top right corner of this page, so I'm going to have a further breakdown. I'm going to have an idea that among the 1066 sequences, 34 belongs to the Homo sapiens. I hope so that you would have an idea that the Homo sapiens are the humans. The 12 belong to muscular, which is a mouse. So that's a breakdown with reference to the organisms about the results. But let's assume for a moment that I'm right now interested in this synthetic construct of the Homo sapiens. CCSBHM. Let's assume I'm interested in this one. So what I will do to get more information about this sequence, I will click on this one. And as I will click on this one, after a few moments, I will be landed to the page which will be specific for this CNGA3 sequence. Here it is page. Now this page contains a lot of information about my gene sequence in which I am right now I'm interested. So let's try to understand that what type of information is actually here. So if you look at the first line, so the first line, there is a word locus, and that locus means that the location, and in front of this locus, there is an alphanumeric number. Now this alphanumeric KR711802 number is also known as the accession number, and this is a unique identifier number which is assigned to my gene sequence in a database. In front of this one, you can actually have an idea about the total length of the gene sequence in which you are interested. Then the type of the sequence, is it a DNA sequence or a RNA sequence, or is it a linear or the circular? And then you are going to have a three-letter code. Like here, I'm going to have a three-letter code SYN. SYN is letting me know that this is a synthetic construct. I am going to also have a date, and this date is a date when the sequence is submitted into the NCBI nucleotide database. In the second line, I'm going to have a brief definition about the gene sequence, which is this information is letting me know that what actually I'm going to have. The third row is an accession. This is an accession number which I have explained to you earlier. So locus and accession number, they both are the same one. There is no difference at all. A unique identifier number assigned to my gene sequence in the database. And then I'm going to have a version number. So you can actually see it here that the version number, accession number, and the locus, they are the same. The version number is a bit different from the accession and the locus. And that is going to have a dot one. In the version, you could have a dot two, dot three, dot four, and dot five. And what that dot is letting you know, this dot is letting you know that how many times this sequence is updated or that sequence is modified. So this is a version number. So I'm going to have an idea that this sequence is modified once after its submission. And then I'm going to have further information like the keywords associated with my gene, the source. Obviously, this is a synthetic construct, so that's why the synthetic construct is written here. If let's assume that that gene sequence is obtained from the human, so here we are going to find out the source as a Homo sapiens and the organism also the Homo sapiens. And then you are going to have a reference. These are the authors. Worked on this gene, and this is actually the title of the paper in which that gene sequence is published. And you are going to have an idea about the journal and some other stuff, which maybe is not so much important for you right now. The second portion here on this page is a feature region, and in feature region, there's a great deal of information present here. Now, in this feature region, I'm going to have an idea about the properties or various characteristics of my gene sequence. For example, is it an exonic? And if it is an exonic, then what type of protein that is going to make? So if I come here at the CDS stands for the coding sequence. So I'm going to have an idea that from a 69 nucleotide to 2150, that's a coding region, which is present in my gene sequence. And this coding region is going to make this protein. This coding region is going to make this protein, as you can see it here. I can copy and paste it to my noteboard to further use in my bioinformatic analysis. So if you come down, and after the feature, you are going to have a gene sequence. This is a gene sequence, and this gene sequence can be written into two different formats. The one is known as GenBank format, and second one is known as the FASTA. Now, in a GenBank format, the sequences are written with the gaps. As you can see it here, that the sequence will be written in the block of 10. So there are the 10 nucleotide in one block, the 10 nucleotide in another block. So in a one row, there are going to be the 6 blocks, and the blocks will be separated with one another with a space. So in a one row, there are total 6 blocks. It means there are total 60 nucleotides. In a second row, again, 60 nucleotides. Then the third row, again, 60 nucleotides, and so on and on and on. Now this is a GenBank format, and one of the main advantage of this GenBank format is that it's very easy to pinpoint or locate your desired or targeted nucleotide. For example, if I'm interested to find out that which one is a 59th nucleotide, then it's very easy for me that the 59th nucleotide will be present in the first row and the last block, second last of the last blocks, it's adenosine, which is a 59th nucleotide. So this is a GenBank format. Now, one of the main disadvantage of the GenBank format is that this format cannot be used in a bioinformatic analysis because this is going to have a numbers, this is going to have a space, and this thing is not acceptable in a further bioinformatic analysis. So, the sequence which is normally going to be used for a bioinformatic analysis, this is a FASTA sequence. And to get the FASTA sequence, I will come at the top of the page and I will click on this FASTA. And when I will click on this FASTA, so I will move to the next page. And on this page, I'm going to have a same sequence, but that same sequence is written in a different format. And this format is a FASTA format. Now, this FASTA format always going to begin with the sign of this greater. You can actually see it here that the sign of greater, then there is going to be the accession number, and then the definition, and then the rest of the sequence, and there is no spaces, no number in the sequence. So this sequence is a perfect for a bioinformatic analysis. Now, keep it in mind that this accession number and this definition can be safely ignored in a FASTA format, but this sign of greater cannot be ignored in a FASTA format. This should be present before the start of the sequence. Now, this is the FASTA format. Now, another very important thing we should remember that this FASTA format or the GenBank format, the sequences are written in 5-3 directions. Keep it into mind that the sequences are always written in 5-3 directions. Now, let's assume for a moment that you want to download this FASTA format sequence in your machine. So to download the FASTA format into your machine, what you can do, you can click on this send to button. And then you are going to have this drop-down menu. And in this drop-down menu, you can actually click on this gene features. And then in the gene features further, you are going to have two options. You want to download the FASTA format. You want to download the nucleotide sequence or another option you could have. So if you are interested to download this FASTA format, so you can actually click on this FASTA nucleotide and you can click on this create file button. And when you will click on this create file button, then after a few moments, that sequence will be downloaded into your system into a notepad format very shortly. So you can save that one wherever you want to save. Let's assume we are interested in save on the desktop. So we will save it to the desktop, and the desktop, this sequence will be saved. Another very important thing, let's assume for a moment that you want to download the multiple sequences in the one shot. For example, I want to align the multiple sequences and for that for the multiple sequence alignment, I need to download the multiple sequences, but that's very laborious that I'm going to the FASTA section of each sequence and then I'm going to download them and then I'm going to copy and paste them into a single file. So what if I want to download all of the sequences in a one shot? Many sequences in a one shot. So in this case, what I can do, I can come to this main result section and then I can click those sequences in which I'm interested. So let's assume I'm interested in this first five sequences for the multiple sequence alignment. So what is a multiple sequence alignment? Don't be worried about it. We will talk about them multiple sequence alignment in later lectures. So let's assume I'm interested in these 6 months. So I will select all of them and then I go to the top, this send to button. I will click on this drop down menu button, then the gene feature, then the FASTA nucleotide, and then I will click on this create file button. And when I will click on this create file button, then after a few moments, this FASTA sequence will be downloaded into my machine. And when it will be downloaded into my machine, so then we can further see it here. When we will open this FASTA nucleotide file, so I can see it here that all of these sequences which I have selected, all of them are downloaded here in a single file, and then this single file can be used further for a bioinformatic analysis. I hope so that this first tutorial will be informative for you to understand that how to browse the NCBI nucleotide database and how to download the genetic information from the NCBI nucleotide database in a FASTA format.